got, now you got actual Israelites that's holding a grudge against the Lord. Like, why would he do this? Why would he do that? Like, bro.
That's the same nigga that was.
You know what I'm saying? And it's you can tell that same energy is back because dudes don't be reading. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? These other groups, they don't read, bro. They don't. But they might. They read what they told to read. I'll say that.
Right.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. The rest of the book escapes them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And they say these outlandish things, not knowing that, that's not a grudge from 2,000 years ago. Yeah. You done left and came back and, you know what I'm saying? It's a whole lot more to it than just that. I would say the Lord is not the author of confusion.
Right.
You know?
Yep.
Tell me why I got to pay for something happened 2,000 years ago. Because you did something 2,000 years ago. Yeah, and then you did something this time. So, yeah, you keep doing shit.
That's why the only, because this is a cycle, as we can see, it's only getting worse. It's a perpetual cycle of constant torture being here on this earth. Keep jacking up within this physical, corruptible body.
Says the darkness.
The only solution to this is Ezekiel 36, man. You know what I'm saying? The law, statutes, and commandments being written in our inward parts. That's the only thing that's going to solve the problem forever.
Yeah.
You know, and that's why Yahushua is so integral, because the only way to get to that is through him. You know?
Shit. I got one more. This is Matthew 23:29. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, because you build the tombs of the prophets and garner the sepulchres of the righteous, and say, if we had been in the days of our fathers, we would not have been partakers with them in the blood of the prophets. Wherefore, ye be witnesses unto yourselves that ye are the children of them which killed the prophets. Fill ye up then the measure of your fathers.
Thank you. Man, that's really nice.
That's it.
Yep, they were back, they were decorating the graves, they were like, these are our great prophets, you know, like, these great men, Isaiah, Jeremiah, we would never do nothing to them if they was back.
Right.
Man. Yeah, they was the same dudes that killed Yahusha?
It is you!
You know, so that shows you that, you know, there's some wolves in sheep's clothing out there, but we're going to focus on doing the Lord's work, and everything else is, you know, going to be brought to the forefront in due time. So, I guess we can continue on here. There's about 10 more, or 8 more verses here in Judges 6.
Judges 6 and verse 30, it says, then the men of the city said unto Joash, bring out thy son that he may die, because he hath cast down the altar of Baal, and because he hath cut down the grove that was by it. And Joash said unto all that stood against him, will you plead for Baal? Will you save him? He that will plead for him, let him be put to death whilst it is yet morning.
Yeah, like basically Joash, which was Gideon's father, he kind of looked out for Gideon, because he obviously was trying to protect his son, but like they were trying to come against him for cutting down Baal's altar. Well, the whole city was worshiping Baal. You know, Joash, Gideon's dad, was like, okay, well, if Baal is this powerful god, why don't you just let Baal take care of him? Let Baal, you know, jack him up then, right? And so that's how Gideon got his name, Jerubbaal, which we're going to get the definition of it. But let's finish that verse real quick.
Got it. It's continuing on. It says, if he be a god, let him plead for himself, because one hath cast down his altar. Therefore, on that day, he called him Jerubbaal, saying, let Baal plead against him, because he hath thrown down his altar.
Right. So Jerubbaal is a compound word. And it means, let me get it real quick, Strong's H3378, Yerah Baal, okay, basically it says, let Baal contend, you know, so, and this was given to Gideon by his father when he destroyed the altar of Baal. So that was kind of the name, that was Gideon's name, and basically to everybody else, they thought that Gideon was cursed for destroying the altar of Baal. Just like how they think that we are condemned for putting horns on Jesus.
They stepping on Jesus.
Yeah, you know, yeah, that's sacrilege, you know. But it's really, there ain't nothing sacred about white man Jesus, man.
They put horns on him.
You see? So that's the thing. So they calling us, you know, whatever, scoffer, they calling us wicked. But it's the same spirit that, you know, our people were in when they were trying to kill Gideon for casting down the altar of Baal, right? Okay, so that's how he got his name. That's how Gideon got his name, Jerubbaal. Okay, Let's continue on, Baruch.
Okay. Verse 33, it says, "Then all the Midianites and the Amalekites and the children of the east were gathered together and went over and pitched in the valley of Jezreel. But the Spirit of the Lord came upon Gideon, and he blew a trumpet. And Abiezer, was gathered after him. And he sent messengers throughout all Manasseh."
Yeah, and Abiezer is a clan, within Israel. Okay, and actually keep going in that verse. Focus up.
Continuing on in verse 35, it says, "Who also was gathered after him, and he sent messengers unto Asher, and unto Zebulun, and unto Naphtali."
Right, so basically he called those men to arms, saying, look, the Spirit of the Lord, again, had previously encouraged him to know that he was going to prevail against the Midianites. And it wasn't just the Midianites we read, it was Midianites and Amalekites, and then men of the east. So basically these other nations, just like how Psalms 83 talks about the Confederate against the nation of Israel, they all basically come together with one consent, trying to sack Israel. You see, but now ain't nothing to sack. So now Esau going to try to come against us now, but what we got? 401ks? Like there's nothing to sack. We're basically in guerrilla warfare mode. You know what I'm saying? Talking about the prophets now, like in the spirit, because this is a spiritual battle. We ain't talking about nothing physical. But basically the point is, you may be able to kill a little bit of the prophets off. Like Revelation 20th chapter talks about, but ultimately the word is going to go out. Well, it's already out. As you can see, Kanye West talking about 12 tribes of Israel. So somebody got to be, preaching something.